Hello to everybody from MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston. I'm George Kalin, and it's my pleasure to introduce you a paper just published in GATT with my colleagues Martin Pichler, now professor in Graz, Christian Rodriguez-Aguayo and Gabriel Lopez-Berenstein from Experimental Therapeutics in MD Anderson. So this is a paper about a new long non-coding RNA, a gene who never codifies for proteins but regulates the function of other genes. And what is peculiar about this long non-coding RNA is that it's a human-specific transcript. And why is this, it's important? It's because the dogma, the mantra of biology and medicine who start decades ago, and here I show an example, the famous Theodosius Dobzhansky with a famous paper, "Nothing in biology makes sense except in the light of evolution." The mantra, the dogma was that what it's very conserved, it's also very important functional. And we operate in medicine and in research under this assumption that you have to identify and focus on genes who are very conserved, on DNA elements who are very conserved. On the other side, we know very well as clinician scientists that cancer mortality, including the one for colorectal cancer, which is a topic of the study, didn't drop significantly in the last 40, 50 years. One exception, metastatic melanoma, due to the wonderful discovery of checkpoint inhibitor therapeutics. And we focus on this paper on a very innovative concept that come out from a brilliant mind, Isidore Rigoutsos, who about 15 years ago discovered in the human genome blocks of 16 nucleotides who are specific only for the human genome. And they are repeated at least 40 times. This intragenomic conservation repetition catch my eye as being a potential indication of functional importance without phylogenetic conservation. And this is how pyknons look in the human genome. Each color, it's a specific 16 mer. And why these are very interesting pieces of the genome? Because they are present in about 250,000 location of the human genome. And in fact, we prove in a paper published in Genome Biology a couple of years ago that these transcript pyknons are basically non-coding RNAs who are human specific. And in the GATT paper, we show a very detailed workflow how to analyze this new transcript that we named FLANC. And FLANC, it's located on chromosome 22. It's located inside the intron of a protein coding genes. And why it's very interesting, it's exactly because in this detailed phylogenetic analysis done by Eric Knudson, FLANC elements, including two ALU repeats, which are, as we all know, human primate specific, are it's present only in the human genome and in few other primates. With this said, we move forward to investigate several cohorts of patients, over 400 patients in total. And here I show you only two cohorts of pair samples who bring up something very interesting for FLANC and for most human-specific genes transcripts. The fact that these are expressed at very low level in normals, while the expression in these states, in this case, colon cancer, it's very high. It's several, if not tens of times higher. And this we prove it by quantitative PCR, and we prove it also by in situ hybridization. You see here very big difference between normal expression and malignant expression. Furthermore, FLANC high level correlate with poor overall survival in several cohorts. By univariate and multivariate, we prove again its clinical significance. Now, the next step was to show that in vivo FLANC tumorigenesis it's related. And in fact, we use ACT-116 xenograft in which we knock down FLANC and the tumor were smaller, and not only smaller, but we were able to produce a mathematical model in which we anticipate what is the size of the tumor with the time course. And here are the images showing a significant reduction in bioluminescence intensity of this ACT116, which modulated FLANC expression. The next question was, what are the mechanisms that are disturbed? And we move away from the dogma one gene, one target, and we create a model in which we both overexpressed and knocked down FLANC expression in the same model, ACT116. Why? Because in this way, we have a Meyer experiment. The downstream targets who are modulated in one way in the knockdown of FLANC should be modulated on the opposite way in the overexpression of FLANC. It's a multiple control experiment. In fact, we found that wing signaling, P53 among others, are behaving in this way. So we got important results that significant pathways known already to be important for colorectal cancer development are under FLANC non-coding RNA regulation. And then we move to the most important and interesting step, the therapeutic targeting in vivo through nanoparticles of these primate-specific non-coding RNAs. And for this, we use DOPC nanoparticles with Gabriel Berenstein-Lopez and Christian Aguayo, and these are nanoparticles already used in clinical trials with siRNAs in humans. And in fact, what we found that if we load these DOPC nanoliposomes with a specific siRNA against FLANC, the liver metastases in the systemic delivery are quite wiped out, quite disappeared. And in fact, this happened through a modification significant of Ki67 mean proliferation and tunnel assay means apoptosis. And with Mihnea Dragomir, what we found that the intrinsic mechanism for this modification is linked to STAT3 phosphorylation and activation of VEGFA, meaning that this human-specific long non-coding RNAs, it's important for angiogenesis. And what is bringing new our studies is bringing, as I told you, several points, genomics, a new long non-coding RNA human-specific, we identified the clinical significance, molecular mechanism, and in vitro and in vivo significance. But what it's important that targeting human-specific transcripts, due to their very low expression in normal cells, we can achieve a pseudo-specificity. Why? Because siRNA or other type of drugs that can target RNAs, for example, small molecules, will be active mostly in the cells where they will find a lot of transcripts of these non-coding RNAs, meaning malignant cells, disease state cells, and not in the normal cells. So this is a pseudo-specificity that we can acquire by using these primate-specific transcripts. And this study, it's, I think, the first one showing this nano-delivery of specific siRNAs for targeting primate human specific transcripts. And number of gut, we were lucky to publish also a review with Mihnea Dragomir, Scott Kopetz, and Jaffer Ajani, who basically presents the concept of non-coding RNA's involvement in gastrointestinal cancers, both molecular mechanisms, biomarkers, and translational utility. And with this one, I want to thank Dr. Elomar and Smith for giving us the possibility to present in a video abstract our paper. I want to thank very much to you who are reading GUT and who you two are listening to these talks, because without the readers, the journals will never survive. And with this, I want to say everyone, thank you and good luck with the discoveries.